Good morning, Standard 7. I am going to start today Chapter 2 of Biology, Tissue. What do you mean by the term tissue? So first we'll know definition of tissue, dear student. Tissue is defined as a group of cells, which are similar in structure and perform a specific function is known as a tissue, dear student. So see, this is the definition of tissue. Tissue is defined as a group of cells which are similar in structure. Means all the cell in a group, all are in same shape and size, and performing a specific function is known as tissue. So dear student, tissue are mainly are of the two type: plant tissue and animal tissue. Tissue are of two types: plant tissue and animal tissue. First, I will explain to you all about the plant tissue. So, dear student, plant tissue are basically are of the two types. First, meristematic tissue. Meristematic tissue. So let us know, what do you mean by meristematic tissue of plant? The tissue which have unique capacity to divide continuously meristematic tissue is present plant. So dear students, let us know about meristematic tissue. That tissue which have unique capacity to divide continuously. Continuously this particular type of the tissue used to divide and help the plant to grow. So meristematic tissue, dear student, basically it is being present in the embryo or baby plant, means small plant, premature plant, small sapling. In all the part, meristematic tissue is present, dear student. Further, meristematic tissue is being classified according to the function in two types. First is apical meristematic and second is cambium or lateral meristematic. So let us know about apical meristematic tissue. Tissue is located in matured plant at the tip, at the apex of the plant and in the tip of the root and help the plant to grow in length, height wise continuously throughout the life of the plant, dear student. So apical meristematic tissue present in the tip of the plant. Dear student, in the tip of the plant. Suppose that this is a plant and it present at the tip. Apical. Present at the tip. Apical meristematic tissue present at the tip and at the tip of the root. Tip of the root and help the plant to grow lengthwise, upward and downward. Okay, dear student. Next is cambium or lateral meristematic tissue. So dear student, what is the function of cambium or meristematic tissue? Cambium or meristematic tissue help the stem of the branch to increase the diameter or thickness of the stem. Thickness of the stem and branches. Stem and branches, dear student. So, cambium or lateral meristematic help to increase the thickness of the stem and branches. So now you came to know about the meristematic tissue. Once again, meristematic tissue basically it is present in the embryo and the baby plant, because almost in all part of the baby plant, meristematic tissue is present and divide continuously and help in growth of the plant. Meristematic tissue are of two type, apical and cambium. Apical meristematic tissue present in the mature plant at the tip, at the top of the plant, and at the down in the root at the base, and help the plant to grow height wise throughout the life of the plant, dear student. Whereas the cambium meristematic tissue, which is present in the stem and the branches, and help to increase the thickness or diameter of the stem. So dear student, in this video you came to know about the meristematic tissue. In the next video I will explain you about the simple permanent tissue and complex permanent tissue. Thank you dear student.